Hello and welcome to Progressive Education Society's Modern College of Pharmacy, Nigri, Pune. Pimple. In this video, we will discuss about the toxicity in herbals and their associated interactions. Specifically, this video focuses upon the toxicity and drug interactions of licorice. Before moving into the detailed toxicities of each drug, we will just have a look at what are the toxicities and what drug interactions are. It is a very common myth that all the natural drugs such as herbal or mineral or animal derived are safe, but it's not so, because we have learned that anything in excess can be injurious to health. So always everything should be taken in a definite proportion. Additionally, if you are consuming certain drugs along with another drugs prescribed by the physician, then there are chances that these two drugs can interact with each other. Normally, it has been observed that in patients suffering from various chronic disorders such as diabetes, arthritis, cancer, or suffering from blood pressure, they invariably consume alternative medicines. Alternative medicines in sense, along with the drugs prescribed by the physician, they also take up the herbal drugs or teas which are advised by their friends or relatives. Now, this is going on routinely because most of the patients and even health practitioners are unaware about herb-drug interaction or food-drug interaction or herb and food interaction. Now, these three commonly can be very, very toxic, can prove to be very toxic, and sometimes can prove to be fatal as well. Foods, herbs or metals and minerals, they interact with the drugs as well as they may interact amongst themselves. Additionally, the magnitude of their interaction, it varies from individual to individual. That means every person has a different makeup of certain enzymes or hormones, and altering the hormonal or enzymatic level can be threatening in various individual and to a different extent. There are two kinds of interactions basically. First is the interactions that can change the pharmacokinetics of the drug, that is absorption, distribution, metabolism and elimination or excretion, or even liberation of the drug. Elimination rate of certain drugs has been found to be affected by the consumption of a certain herbal drugs or by co-administration of certain herbal drugs. Now, the elimination rate can either be increased or can be decreased. Further, the release profile of the drug which is released from its dosage form, is hampered in presence of certain herbal drug. It can either increase the release profile or sometimes can decrease the release profile of the drug from the dosage form. Next is interaction. There are other interactions which can prove to be affect the pharmacodynamics of the drugs, such as the cellular membrane disruption of certain drugs, then chemical reaction, direct chemical reaction in the blood with certain synthetic or herbal drugs, or also they may lower the effectiveness of certain synthetic drugs. Another kind of interaction in pharmacodynamics is by altering the enzyme proteins or altering the structural proteins of our plasma or carrier proteins, and also by affecting the ion channels. So in order to if the herbal drugs, they are interacting with the ion channels, they may increase or decrease the absorption of the synthetic drug. potency of the drug or the target site at which the drug was supposed to act can be changed altogether in presence of certain food or herbs. Major herbal drugs that show their toxicity and interaction and are routinely consumed in the day-to-day life are licorice, cinnamon, amla, ginseng, garlic, digitalis, turmeric, ephedra, and cinchona. Here we will be having a look at licorice first. Licorice, as we all know, is it contains dried peeled or unpeeled roots or even rhizomes of Glycyrrhiza glabralin belonging to family Leguminosae. Licorice extracts are directly sold into the market, or sometimes the standardized licorice extracts that contains glycyrrhizin or glycyrrhizic acid are supplied into the market, and these are routinely used in food products or tobacco products or as a snuff, and also majorly it is used in traditional systems of medicines. Next, applications of licorice extracts are basically at a larger level in cigarette tobacco or chewing tobacco, because it is used at a concentration of around 1-4% in order to enhance the flavor or harmonize the characteristic of the smoke. Further, it has been proven that licorice extract imparts moisture holding characteristic to the tobacco and also acts as a surface active agent for spraying or for coating different ingredients or flavors on the tobacco. Licorice flavored candies, soft drinks, or herbal teas are available in the Western world to a larger extent in the market. Medicinal applications of licorice, there are many. To list a few, licorice has invariably been used as an expectorant or for treatment of gastric ulcers, Addison's disease, liver disorders, and it can also be used as a laxative. Natural licorice has mineralocorticoid and glucocorticoid property. Higher doses of licorice extract that has been enriched with glycyrrhizinic acid can prove to be hypokalemic, that is, it eliminates out potassium from the urine and decreases the blood potassium level. Thereby, it can cause hypertension, because potassium is exchanged with sodium. When sodium comes in, potassium goes out. So once sodium comes in, it is not coming along itself. It brings water along with it into the body. Therefore, it causes hypermineralocorticoidism, that means retention of water in the body plus elimination of minerals out of the body. Glycyrrhizinate inhibits very important enzyme called as 11-beta-hydroxysteroid dehydrogenase. There are two types of that. Type 2 is prominently inhibited by glycyrrhizinate. This is the enzyme which is responsible for inactivating cortisol. The detailed mechanism of the toxicity of glycyrrhizinates, we will have a look in the next slide. Here, we will first have a look at the normal function of the kidney. Kidneys, they release cortisol, and the cortisol, when it is released, it increases the sodium and water absorption from distal convoluted tubule. Also, simultaneously, it pushes the potassium and hydrogen into the urine. That means the urine potassium level and hydrogen level will be increased. Now, if the cortisol is doing this continuously, that can lead to increased extracellular volume because sodium and water has been absorbed now. So water around the cell will increase, causing increase in extracellular volume. This can further increase the blood pressure and edema of a particular region or extremities. Generally, lower extremities are affected. So swollen feet can be the one of the major symptom in this case. Additionally, decrease in the potassium level causes hypokalemia, that means weakness and muscle spasm. Further, decreased hydrogen level in the body can lead to metabolic alkalosis. The blood becomes alkaline. But this normally does not happen. Our blood remains in a definite pH of 7.4. And our body is never suffering from muscle spasm and so normally. That is because of the enzyme called as 11 beta hydroxysteroid dehydrogenase. Now this is the enzyme that prevents or that inhibits or that controls the cortisol. If cortisol is controlled, this is a negative feedback mechanism. When the body is short of water, cortisol is secreted, and when the body has more amount of water, in that case 11 beta hydroxysteroid is secreted, and this inhibits the cortisol from further uptaking potassium, sodium and water level. Therefore, body fluids remain at a normal level, and this kind of process does not occur. That means 11 beta hydroxysteroid prevents this condition. Now what happens is, if you are consuming glycyrrhizinates or liquorice at a higher concentration, or routinely if you are chewing or consuming liquorice extracts or liquorice compound products, the glycyrrhizinates in them, they inhibit this 11 beta hydroxysteroid. Now if this enzyme is inhibited, the control over cortisol is lost. Therefore, the blockage or inhibition is lost, and then this condition will reappear, making a person hypertensive, or it can increase the edema, it can cause muscle weakness, spasm and metabolic alkalosis. That is the reason why glycyrrhizinate should not be consumed at a larger level. The symptoms of liquorice toxicity can be listed like it increases the blood pressure because it increases the blood volume level by uptaking sodium and water at DCT. Fatigue, muscle cramping, then spasm, tetanism, prolonged contraction of muscles, skeletal muscles, and weakness is particularly observed due to hypokalemia, reduced potassium in the blood level. Dark urine can be observed, that means myoglobin is the protein that is eliminated out of the body when potassium salt in the body is at a lower level. When potassium decreases in the blood, myoglobin goes into the urine. Myoglobin has blackish coloration, that is why, and it is water soluble. That is why the urine appears to be darker in color. Excessive fluid retention can cause polyuria, frequent urination, or nocturia, that means urination at the night. Edema is the accumulation of water. So swollen feet or swollen face or water is lodged at the near the lungs or important organs. Dyspnea, difficulty in breathing because water is lodged around the lungs, and it reduces the volume required for the expansion of lungs. So the lungs are unable to expand at a normal volume, so it feels difficulty in breathing. Headache is caused due to hypertension because already the blood volume has been increased. paresthesias or diesthesias, that is the burning sensation exhibited at extremities, palms and soles, they show burning sensation. Impotence and diminished libido, that means desire for sex is lost due to reduction in the potassium level, and also licorice, it has direct effect on sex hormones. Amenorrhea in females, absence of menstrual cycle can also be experienced if the female is consuming or licorice routinely. In order to determine the licorice toxicity, various laboratory tests are suggested. The first and the simplest test is blood pressure. Elevated blood pressure accompanied by increased urine free cortisol level. The cortisol is lost in urine. Then decreased level or sometimes even absence of aldosterone in the urine can be seen. Lower serum potassium level, potassium level in the blood is diminished. Increased urinary potassium level, you can check the urine level of potassium and you will find excessive amount of potassium in the urine. Hematocrit count, that means RBC, WBC or hemoglobin count, is found to be reduced because the blood volume is increased. That means the blood has been diluted now by filling out more and more amount of water. But the proportion of hemoglobin is determined as gram per 100 ml, or RBCs are counted as cubic per lakhs per mm cube. So the since the blood has been diluted, the hematocrit count was found to be reduced. Myoglobinuria, the urine color is darkened. Serum creatinine kinase as well as creatinine phosphokinase level, it is increased, and this increased level can be toxic and can cause tubular necrosis. That means the nephrons can die because of elevated level of serum creatinine. If you are consuming licorice, or if the patient is consuming licorice, he should be advised to stop consuming licorice in certain conditions such as pregnancy and breastfeeding, because licorice can cause miscarriage or early delivery in certain pregnant lady. High blood pressure increased. If a person is suffering from blood pressure, he should be advised not to consume licorice because it will further worsen the condition, hypertensive condition. Heart diseases, patients suffering from heart diseases are advised not to consume licorice because it stores the water in the blood and it can make the congestive heart failure worse. Licorice also alters the heart rate, therefore there are chances that it can cause arrhythmia. If a person is suffering from kidney diseases, overuse of licorice can worsen the situation. Surgery, if a person is about to undergo surgery, he should be advised not to consume licorice at least 7 to 15 days prior to the surgery, as licorice can increase the blood pressure, and hence controlling the blood pressure during or as well after the surgery is very, very essential and critical. Patients suffering from sexual problems such as erectile dysfunction can avoid licorice because it lowers the testosterone level and also it lowers the urge for desire. Major drug interactions of licorice are found to be with warfarin, which is commonly known as coumadin. Warfarin is an anticoagulant drug. Normally, if you are consuming warfarin, the body breaks down warfarin. in order to get rid of it. That means it is a normal mechanism of the liver that it reduces the warfarin concentration in the blood. Licorice, it interferes in the breakdown. That means it fastens up or it stimulates the breakdown of warfarin, thereby decreases the effectiveness of warfarin. Therefore, the persons consuming warfarin, they can experience risk of clotting or sometimes blockage, because warfarin was used as an anticoagulant and its effectiveness has been decreased. So the blood can coagulate at a capillary level, causing. Other moderate interactions are found to be with digoxin, wherein digoxin, it directly acts on sodium potassium ATPase pump and it treats the congestive heart failure. But licorice, since it lowers the potassium level, therefore it also decreases the effectiveness of digoxin. Digoxin does not find potassium in the blood to treat the CHF. With estrogens, licorice normally changes the sex hormone level in the body. Licorice decreases the effectiveness of certain estrogen pills. Estrogen pills are used as a contraceptive pills or drugs. Certain estrogen pills are Premarin, ethinyl estradiol or estradiol. These should not be consumed along with licorice, as their effectiveness is lost. Furosemide, which is a potent diuretic, it reduces the blood potassium level, and licorice also reduces the blood potassium level. And if you are co-administering licorice along with furosemide, it can be threatening, because it severely affects the potassium level in the body. Similarly, potassium sparing diuretics like amiloride, allurenone or spironolactone can prove to be problematic, because licorice changes decreases the potassium level, and these diuretics also decrease the potassium level. So cumulative reduction in the potassium level can prove to be life-threatening to the patient. Lastly, most of the antihypertensives such as captopril, enalapril, losartan, valsartan or diltiazem and amlodipine, they are found to show interaction with licorice, because licorice increases the blood pressure, and if you are consuming antihypertensives, the dose of these antihypertensives needs to be adjusted in order to get their effect.